This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, in the previous two video lectures of General Organic Chemistry, I talked about inductive effect. I told you what is inductive effect. I told you different groups of positive inductive effect and negative inductive effect. In this session, I will start the discussion of applications of inductive effect. The application here is to determine acidic strength of carboxylic acid. First of all, the formula of carboxylic acid is RCOOH. When carboxylic acid dissociates, it gives RCO minus plus H plus. This is carboxylic acid. This is carboxylate ion. Now, its acidic strength will depend upon how easily it releases this H plus. Means in the forward direction. In the forward direction. And this dissociation will be in the forward direction, more in the forward direction, if this carboxylate ion is less basic, or better I say more stable. So I can write here more stable carboxylate ion implies more forward process, which is actually dissociation of carboxylic acid. And more dissociation implies stronger acid. My point is clear. And in the chapter ionic equilibrium, we have talked about conjugate acid base theory. I'll tell you here. This theory says if parent acid is strong, its conjugate base will be weak. And if parent acid is weak, its conjugate base will be strong. This is conjugate acid base theory. And RCOO minus, that is carboxylate ion, is actually conjugate base of parent RCOH, that is carboxylic acid. So if we are able to find the basic strength of this carboxylate ion, we will be able to predict the acidic strength of the parent. So we have to check basically the basic strength of this carboxylate ion. But first of all, we need to know, why do we call this carboxylate ion as a base? Why do we say this compound as a base? So let me tell you, this is base because oxygen has lone pair. You can see this oxygen is having lone pair. And that is why it is Lewis base. You all are aware of Lewis base. We have done this in ionic equilibrium. Lewis base is the compound which has a lone pair and tendency to donate the lone pair. And since its basic strength is because of a lone pair present on this oxygen, so what conclusion we can draw from here? More electron density on oxygen of RCOO minus implies more basic carboxylate ion. My point is clear. More electron density on oxygen of RCO minus, that is carboxylate ion, implies more basic strength. And here I will tell you that inductive effect is responsible for this increase or decrease in the electron density on this oxygen. And now how? To explain inductive effect here, I will take two examples. One is CH3CH2COOH, propionic acid, and another is ClCH2COOH. This is chloroacetic acid. Now, to compare the acidic strength of these two carboxylic acids, I will write the conjugate base. For first, the conjugate base will be CH3CH2COO-. And for second, it is ClCH2COO-. So these two are the conjugate bases of the given acids. So if I want to compare the acidic strength of these two carboxylic acids, I need to compare the basic strength of these two carboxylate ions. Now, just check this. This is the common part. This is the common part. So the change in the electron density on this oxygen will be because of the difference part. My point is clear. And as we know, more the electron density on oxygen, more will be the basic strength of the carboxylate ion. CH3, this is a plus I effect group. Plus I effect group. Plus I effect means electron releasing. Electron releasing. CH3 is electron releasing group. Since CH3 is electron releasing group, it will push the electrons towards oxygen, and this way the electron density on oxygen increases. While Cl, Cl is what? Cl is minus I effect group. And minus I effect group means electron withdrawing group. And electron withdrawing group means it will pull the electrons towards it, and this way electron density on oxygen decreases. So what conclusion we can draw from here? This is less basic and this is more basic. And now conjugate acid base theory. If the conjugate base is more basic, its parent will be less acidic. And this is less basic, so its parent will be more acidic. So out of these two, this chloroacetic acid is more acidic than propionic acid. My point is clear. This way, we explain the acidic strength of carboxylic acid using inductive effect. Now, you can see here, I have written the conclusion. If electron withdrawing group is attached with the COOH, then it decreases the basic strength of conjugate carboxylate ion, and as a result, acidic strength of parent carboxylic acid increases. Let me tell you one more thing. Less basic strength of carboxylate ion implies more stability of carboxylate ion. More stability of carboxylate ion implies more acidic strength of the parent carboxylic acid. You can see, as a result, acidic strength of parent carboxylic acid increases. More stable carboxylate ion implies more acidic parent carboxylic acid. But if electron releasing group is attached with the COH, then it increases the basic strength of conjugate carboxylic ion, and as a result, acidic strength of parent carboxylic acid decreases. A very, very, very special conclusion. And now, if I write here electron withdrawing group, if I attach this electron withdrawing group with the COH, it is electron pulling group. And here from the conclusion, we can say its acidic strength will be greater than the carboxylic acid where electron releasing group is attached. The point is clear. Now, with the help of this conclusion and this discussion, we will solve few questions here. Here the question says, compare the acidic strength of benzoic acid and aliphatic carboxylic acid. The formula of benzoic acid is C6H5COH, and aliphatic carboxylic acid I can write RCOH. This question is very easy, and this can be explained very easily with the help of conclusion part. Here you can see C6H5 is actually a minus I effect group. Minus I effect group, electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group attached with COOH. And R is alkyl. Alkyl is plus I effect group. Means electron releasing group attached with COOH. And in the conclusion, we have said that electron withdrawing group increases the acidic strength of carboxylic acid. So, this benzoic acid will be more acidic as compared to aliphatic carboxylic acid. Let me tell you, this we have written in a generalized manner. So actual acidic strength will depend upon this R also. But in majority of the cases, we can say that benzoic acid is more acidic than the aliphatic carboxylic acid. My point is clear. Now, I'll take another question here. You can see here, question says, compare the acidic strength of these carboxylic acids. This will be solved with the help of inductive effect. As we know, alkyl group is a plus I effect group. Plus I effect group. Alkyl group is a plus I effect group. And CH3, 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 C. This is tertiary butyl. This is tertiary butyl. And this is isopropyl. Then CH3CH, this is ethyl, then methyl, and one is H. If you compare the difference in all given carboxylic acids, these are the common part, COH, COH everywhere. So, difference is here. Difference is in the alkyl group attached. And as we know, the plus I effect of this tertiary butyl will be maximum. You can see maximum branching at the carbon which is attached with COH. So maximum plus I effect, and then this, then this, then this, and then this. So this is the order of plus I effect. And more plus I means more electron releasing tendency. And as we have concluded in the discussion, that electron releasing group will decrease the acidic strength. So more electron releasing tendency implies less acidic carboxylic acid. So out of these, the number one acid will be HCOH. HCOH will be the strongest among given carboxylic acids. Then CH3COOH, then CH3CH2COOH, then CH3CHCOOH, and then CH3CCOOH. My point is clear. Now I'll take another question here. Again, here also we have to compare the acidic strength of these carboxylic acids. And if I write this structure, this is first, then this is the second, and then this is the third carboxylic acid. This is the common part. This is the common part. The difference is here, and we know Cl is minus I effect group. Minus I effect group means electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group. And in the third case, you can see maximum chlorine atoms. In all the cases, we have one carbon other than COH, and that carbon in the third case is attached with 3Cl. So maximum negative inductive effect. So maximum electron withdrawing. Then this, and then this. So more minus I effect implies more acidic parent RCOH. So out of these three, the number one acidic will be this carboxylic acid, then this, and then this. So this question we can easily solve with the help of the conclusion that we have discussed in this session. Now I'll take another question here. Here again, we have to compare the acidic strength of given carboxylic acids. Now students, please note that the comparison of acidic strength will be on the basis of differences. So first, look at the common part. In all the cases, this five-membered ring is attached with COH. In every case, five-membered ring is attached with COH. So this is the common part. This is the common part. In first case, NO2 is attached. In the second case, CH3 is attached with the ring. In the third, NO2, fourth, Cl is attached. Fifth, nothing is attached. Now, NO2. NO2 is actually a minus I effect group. Minus I effect group means electron withdrawing group. CH3 is a plus I effect group. Plus I effect group means electron releasing group. Cl is minus I effect group. Minus I effect again, electron withdrawing group. So those cases where electron withdrawing groups are attached, the acidic strength of the carboxylic acid will be more, because we have already concluded that electron withdrawing group, when attached with carboxylic COH, then its acidic strength increases. So, in the first case, we have electron withdrawing. In the third case, we have electron withdrawing. And in the fourth case, we have electron withdrawing. And let me tell you that NO2, the minus I effect of NO2 is greater than Cl. This we had discussed in the previous two sessions. The inductive effect, minus I effect of NO2 is greater than Cl. So, that case where NO2 is attached, the carboxylic acid will be more acidic. And out of 1 and 3, if you compare, NO2 is more closer in case of 3. And as we know, inductive effect is distance dependent. So, more closer NO2 will pull electrons more, and that is why the acidic strength will be more. So out of 5, this third one is the most acidic, and then this first one, and first and fourth, as I told you, NO2 is more electron withdrawing, so it will be greater than, first will be greater than fourth. And in second and fifth, if you compare, the second has got electron releasing group. So its acidic strength will be less, while fifth will be more. So second will be the least, and here I will write 5 and then 2. I hope my point is clear. This was the application of inductive effect. In the next session of general organic chemistry, I will take another application of inductive effect. Thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test, and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.